Hello aspirants, I am AK Mishra, founder and chairman of Chanakya RAS Academy. I welcome you all to this program Success Speaks. As you know, this program I have designed especially for you, demystify a lot of things related to civil service examination. Most of you always have a fear whether you can do it or you cannot do it. That's why I select one candidate in every episode and make you understand that the fears are fears, their realities could be different. So today with me in the studio is Sumit Kumar, who has got All India 53 rank. It is his third attempt in which he got it, and his journey is really interesting for you because he began from a small village background of Bihar, and today he has reached here after his three attempts. In the first attempt, he could not clear pre. In the second attempt, he got All India 493 rank and was allotted Indian Defence State Services. And today, after getting 53 rank, now he's going to be allotted Indian Administrative Service. So welcome, Sumit, to the studio. Thank with you. All congratulations and best wishes.
Thank you,
sir. How are you feeling after getting this rank?
Sir, this year the enthusiasm has been less because when you get selected first time, it was more. So the last year, I was very elated and happy that I have got the results, and I had the confidence in me that I will surely succeed the next time and get into IAS.
It means that in the very second attempt, you had got this clarity that what I have got now, I'm fully prepared, and whatever I have missed, now I'll cover up and get this rank also. Yes. So you have got 53 rank. But how your all journey began? What has been your family background? Which place you are from? Just tell us in brief.
Sir, my father and my native town belongs to a village background, and I was being shifted to one of the hostels at the age of 8 years, and from then I have been away from home, and it is the vision of my parents to send me to a place where I could get an education of very high quality, be it primary, secondary, higher education, so that my career is set accordingly.
This is very interesting for the audience to know. You said your father sent to hostel at the age of 8. Mostly it is done by the people who have high economic resources and everything. So it would be very, very important for the audience to understand what has been background of your father, what he does, and why, how this idea of sending to hostel came in his mind.
Since he couldn't do much in his life, and my family is well educated, my father has around say 5 brothers and 6 sisters, and everybody is away from the village, and he is the lone person who is in the village.
What he does, what is his profession?
He is a goldsmith, and he very well devotes his, he does hard work, and he always thinks about his children. So,
but this is interesting to know, a person who could not do much as compared to other brothers. Normally in such cases, a person gets inferiority complex that I could not do it. But what kind of strength do you see in your father, which really started making him dreaming about you?
He is very patient and perseverance. I have inculcated these qualities from him. He always has something in mind and he always does it. And he passes on these qualities to me also. So he had the vision that since he couldn't do it, he will ensure that his children do it. And we are equally successful, and they wanted us to become very much responsible citizens of the country and do well in our career and think for the nation.
What's your father's name and which place you belong to?
My father's name is Shri Sushil Kumar, and he belongs to Sikandra block in Jammu district of Bihar.
Okay. So when you moved to the hostel at the age of 8 only, do you remember your journey, how that happened and how you reached up to engineering to Kanpur?
So there was a moment when father sacrificed his good food and good clothes to pay the fees of mine in the hostels. And successfully, I managed to be the topper of the school, and I was receiving a scholarship each year of around 40,000 rupees. The fees of the school was 50,000. So in the 5 years of school in Madhupur, in the state of Jharkhand, I managed to do 1 year of 5 years of study in 1 year school fees. So that was the help for him to ensure that he continued my studies. And after that, I went to Bokaro in state of Jharkhand only,
right,
where I further continued the studies. After passing 12th in the fresher attempt, I cleared IIT JEE and I went to IIT Kanpur. There also I received the scholarship, which helped me in ensuring that my studies went well. And after that, I pursued 2 years of job in a private company named PricewaterhouseCoopers Private Limited, where I ensure that I saved enough money for my preparation.
This is very interesting because you have supported each other. Your father dreamt of that. Then you, with your hard study and sincere study, you earned scholarship for yourself and made it possible. So it can be a joint venture of economic management in the family, which you have done. This is really very interesting. Now, to begin with, you know, there is always a demotivation factor, whether I can do it or you cannot do it. Most of the people coming from the rural areas or humble economic background, they have a think whether it is possible for them or not. So what message you would like to give to them?
They are lack in confidence. So it is important for them to realize their potential. Once they are being clear on this, they can achieve anything, because the hardship they face is much greater than what the other people who are belong to economic background face. So that belief has to be put inside the brains of them, and then once that is realized, that potential is made aware of to them, they can achieve anything.
Normally, actually, the challenges which come in the life, people take it as a curse of God, or maybe they are not lucky enough. This has been my experience also in my life, and also while dealing with the students all through, that only those people succeed in life who take all the challenges and opportunity as their opportunities to succeed in their life. If there are troubles, there are problems on their life, they should be taken as challenges, not as curse on them.
Right.
And this is what comes in your life also, right?
Yes.
Now, after completing this education, when this idea of IAS came in your mind, concrete idea, like one idea was given to you by your father that I want to see an IAS, but that is a dream. The idea comes in reality when you conceive in your mind, and then you start working sincerely for that. So when that idea really got concretized in your mind?
The concrete idea of becoming IAS came in third year of college, where alumni of my college who already had become IPS, IFS or IAS officers, and they came to our college to basically give a lecture on what is the profile of the services. So I decided to attend that lecture, and the interaction we had in that course was that the impact which IAS officer or other bureaucrat does in his career is very huge. For example, a district consists of around 14 lakhs, 15 lakhs of people. So you can actually manage that district and make impact on those huge number of people. So that idea actually convinced me to pursue this civil service as a career.
See, you had an option to work in the corporates, get high salary package, but that you sacrificed. You said, I have to do something where you could be close to the public, deal with the issues and problem of society, and contribute to the nation building. So that is something which really is inspiring behind you. Now, well begun is half done. This is the old saying, right? Civil service examination is taken by most of the students as really very difficult to crack, right? You also have gone through 3 stages, years of preparation. You could not make in the pre. Your second attempt, you got selected for with a rank of 493, and the final attempt 53. So it has been very interesting journey. So the people who want to begin with kind of your background, what suggestion would like to give to them that they can make a solid strategy for their preparation?
3 things are important in this: your hard work, your consistency, and the right approach to this exam. So I want to emphasize on the third aspect, because first you are self-explanatory. This exam is not so transparent because you are not shown your weaknesses through your mains copies. So you have to work the other way around, in which you have to ask the toppers about their strategies and then adapt according to your personal strategy. You can ask for around 4 to 5 toppers about their studies and then imitate those and be successful.
Or you can watch the interviews and such program, or even the Success Speaks program.
Yes.
That would help the students to analyze.
I have also watched the Success Speaks and other interviews of the toppers which comes. So this has been very helpful for me to frame the right strategy and then particularly follow the approach which I have personally built.
See, the right strategy in that includes also newspaper reading, because current affairs has a major share in this whole examination. It has to be connected with the current perspective. So which newspaper to read, how to read is also a question, right? So what newspaper you were reading?
I read Indian Express. It is important to read one newspaper because two newspapers becomes very
difficult
to manage time wise.
Newspaper reading is an art. Some people keep wasting 4-5 hours in that. Ideal condition is 1.5 hour something, 1 hour you can read. So how to identify which is relevant to read, which is not relevant to read in newspaper? What has been your approach?
It is important that you cover the issue aspect in the newspapers rather than superficial news. So it is important that you go through the syllabus and past 5 years question papers and what has been being asked in the past 5 years. UPSC always is one step ahead of the candidates thinking. So you have to cast that approach and see that the issue which you read through newspaper and grab is holistic and it is directly the issue part. So you have to extract those things from the newspapers. It actually gradually evolves with time. And you will get to understand the issue which has to be read from the newspaper.
Basically, one has to be clear about the syllabus. This is first thing. Second thing, previous year question. So that will give a kind of guidance and clarity for that. Then there are so many things in the newspaper. But what as an administrator you should focus on is important. Now there are certain pages like what is the importance of first page? Let's discuss a bit on that. What is this importance of the first page to read?
The first two pages which I read in Indian Express was the basic news, which
are really burning issues and any current news, right?
So this is basically superficial news on which issues has to be dealt, and it is given in the newspaper in the editorial sections.
So then it comes the editorial section. You can have highlights of the news in the first page and the news page, but to get issue based information you should read editorial pages thoroughly, right?
Also in Indian Express there is a page on explained section where a issue is dealt end to end holistically. So that particular thing,
which page is that?
Explained. So that page has also benefited me because I am always curious about the things which happen. So it gives me entire information and also deals the topic issue wise. So and those two sections, editorial and explained, are the most important ones according to me. And then comes the world part.
World news.
So you have to be cautious that you don't understand only the news part. You have to understand what affects on India, the policies which developed and developing countries frame, or the regional and global grouping frame. The impact on India has to be understood and studied accordingly.
Did you prepare some notes also out of the newspaper?
Yes, sir. So initially I used to make huge notes which became voluminous and couldn't study. So from that particular thing I realized that it has to be very crisp and has to deal end to end holistically. So whenever a newspaper came daily, so I used to make a particular topics wise notes, and whatever things came after reading gradually I used to make an amendment in those notes and I used to further elaborate on those.
It means that you created some basic structure on the burning issues and the matter, and you keep changing and supplementing the facts and figures which started coming on that. Is it you want to say?
Yes. So I used A4 sheet notes which I used to keep in files. So whenever some addition comes in between those issues, I used to basically put up in file and then and there write it from newspapers.
Or if any has replacement, then old things can be removed and the new page you could insert that way. The idea is to remain connected with it. Now, since we are talking about current affairs on the whole, so newspaper is one part of that. Did you read some magazines also? or did you watch some television program or radio? Would you like to highlight that also?
Yes. So, initially in the 2 years of my preparation, I used to read newspapers. In that period, I basically understood the whole holistic things, the happenings which happen in the national or international arena. After that, I found that it is becoming monotonous and my efficiency is getting reduced by reading newspapers. So what I did during mains was I used to read current affairs magazines, which deals the news for the last 1 year. And I used to make notes then and there through those magazines. But it has to be kept in mind that newspaper reading is important for the personality test stage.
You're right. Yeah.
So the newspapers which I left for mains came back. And that came back by reading two newspapers for the personality test stage.
So you made a combination of all the things there. The idea is that whether you watch television or you read newspaper, some discussion so that you have the different perspectives being cleared and all there. Sumit, basically, time management also is a very crucial thing in this exam, right? Because students feel that they might have to read for maybe 15, 17 hours, 18 hours. And they will have to sacrifice everything in their life and they work on that, right? What is your experience? How much time you are devoting to your study on a regular basis?
The civil service examination preparation of mine was a 3.5 years of investment. Mm. So in the initial 2 years, I used to read around 10 hours daily. And gradually after that, I reduced it to 8 hours. Mm-hmm. Because it is important for me to pursue hobby also. Because it gives me relief from the tiring studies which I do every day.
Right.
So it is important to have a balance between studies and the fun you have.
So basically in the initial years you needed 10 hours, but gradually you developed efficiency to do the same thing in 8 hours.
Yes.
One thing. Secondly, what is important is you also practiced hobby. What was your hobby?
Sir, my hobby was watching TED Talks and playing cricket. Apart from this, I am basically a sport person. So I also play badminton, volleyball. So
that's also good.
So I usually try to remain fit also. So these are the hobbies which
even in the UPSC, one special column is in about the hobbies. Many of the students, they think that they just have to be studious. They don't need hobbies, but hobbies are also very, very important to recreate you, regenerate you, and to keep you completely charged on that. So that is what you have been doing. So time management, basically you decided your priorities, you made your health also good, keeping yourself fit physically also is very important. And so that you don't waste time falling sick time and again, that is also very important. And more important is how effectively you are working, not the number of hours, that's how many hours has to be read.
Hello friends, my name is Dilip Pratap Singh Shekhawat. I have secured All India Rank 72 in this year's Civil Services Examination 2018. And now I am here to share my experiences of the mock interview for UPSC. I think mock interview for UPSC is very, very important because it helps you to assess your level of preparation for the actual personality test at the UPSC. So in this context, mock interviews always help you to give a very good feedback about your strengths as well as your weaknesses. So you can always gain confidence from your strengths as well as you can learn from your weaknesses and rectify them in due course of time. In this sense, I would like to mention the role of Chanakya RAS Academy. The mock interview which I gave at the Chanakya RAS Academy was very helpful for me because it was the last mock interview which I gave before the actual interview of UPSC, and it really helped me to gain that confidence level back. Because I was facing a very low because my final interview, mock interview, didn't go really well. Because I was facing such problems, like I was nervous before the interview, and hence I went to Chanakya RAS Academy, gave a mock interview there, and the board was very professional, it was very cordial. They asked me all the questions related to my biodata, they assessed my personality in a very nice manner and boosted my confidence in the right time. And that helped me to go with full confidence in the actual interview. And in this way, I was able to get very good marks in the interview, which helped me secure IAS in this attempt.
NCERT books reading is also always the fundamental things which we suggest, most of the people will suggest. So in NCERT book, what was your approach which you would like to suggest to others?
NCERT, I considered it to be a brief notes of all the issues you study in this exam. So NCERT has to be covered by revising it multiple times, and the notes making of NCERT I would not suggest, because it itself is a crisp notes of whatever you study.
It is better to mark the lines on that, and maybe inside you can write the brief of that, right?
And NCERTs are to be studied in the context of the past year question papers and the syllabus. So, and it gives you a particular style of reading all the other books, which you will gradually do after reading NCERTs.
So, this basically helps you in clearing all the fundamentals,
yes,
and creating a structure. Then you can build your further studies and answers on the structure which has been created there. And NCERT, how many times you read NCERT?
Sir, miss, I have lost the count actually.
Several times, it means, right?
So, I think there was one book of geography and history that is so much underlined that even other people see it and they become fearful of it.
Okay, how many times? So, that's the idea. Reading same book several times is more important rather than one book one time and getting confused. This is the message which is coming from your thing.
It is important.
You read it. It lies the things there, right?
It is important to read one book 10 times rather than 10
books one time.
Yes.
And that is not good. So, it is not a question of completing the books. It's a question of being precise.
Yes.
Mostly students go for voluminous studies of books and they say that, okay, they can do well because IAS exam is there. So, they should not read the thin books, right?
Yes,
idea is that they should read relevant things according to the syllabus.
Yes.
And previous year's questions must be kept in mind. Always there. Sumit, let's discuss about the preliminary examination, which is really very challenging. Large number of students appear, and even you could not make in the first attempts. So, to be safe and secured in the preliminary examination, what are the best things you can suggest?
What I learned from the first attempt and which worked for me in the second attempt was that I had enough knowledge in both the attempts. What I lacked in was the practice which I did for prelims in the first and the second attempt. In the first attempt, I took around 3 to 4 tests, while in the second attempt, I ensured that I would take more than 30 tests.
Oh, very big number of them, right?
Yes. So, that was a 10 times jump from the earlier attempt. And I ensured that I revised all the tests. The knack of taking tests is that you get to know what strategy you have to follow. So, there are people who attempt around 70 questions or get qualified. But there are also people who take around above 90 question attempts and then they become successful. So, the latter was the strategy of mine, because I used to make lots of mistakes and my accuracy hit ratio was not so appropriate. So, through test, I developed that how many...
So, you mean to say test is one important thing which one should try, but then study, first the study base and how to memorize things, how to keep in mind, and syllabus is quite extensive. So, what kind of approach you adopted to ensure that you have studied most of the things there?
So, the revision is the key in all the stages of the exam. So, I ensured that I read one book and revised it multiple times. And this test, practice papers and the study goes in tandem with each other. So, whatever mistakes you do in the test papers, you analyze that and ensure that you read those particular topics more carefully than the other ones. So, here prioritization of topics also helps in clearing the exam.
Okay, that's very good. And now talking about the main examination, what are the difference, fundamental differences or similarity which you have to make between pre and mains?
Generally, there is an integrated approach to both.
That is the best approach.
But you have to adapt according to the questions asked in both the exams. Prelims is basically a horizontal knowledge test exam, while mains is vertical knowledge test exam. So, you have to deep dive into the issues to study basically in the preparation.
But you have to go deeper inside the matter in the main examination.
Mm-hmm. So, I basically what I did was whenever prelims exam came, 2 or 3 months before it, I went to the mode of horizontal knowledge. And after prelims exam, I went to the mode of vertical knowledge. And I prepared the issue wise notes of mains examination and revised it multiple times to ensure that I answer the questions well in the mains examination.
Very good. So, basically the writing skill has to be worked on. There could be some issues and problems, best studies to make on all the subjects there. Optional subject is very important and selection of that. You are engineer, but you have taken anthropology. So, what are the basic parameters on which you can select an optional subject?
The parameters of selecting my optional subject was simple. that your mind goes into the studying of that particular optional. You are devoted to study multiple times particular optional. Second is the availability of material and guidance for that particular optional. Third is how the optional is faring in the civil service examination. There might be a case that you are very good in a college background subject, but that optional may not be faring well according to
the trend which is going on. So, but anyway, your first choice was the interest in the subject, which is very, very important. Mm-hmm. If you don't have interest, the other things will not follow up there. That is very important. And how much time you took to prepare your anthropology?
Sir, I took around 5-6 months.
So it means that in 5-6 months, a candidate can take any new optional and can prepare.
Yes.
There is no need of having really background in graduation also, mm-hmm. or post-graduation. Even if you don't have background, 5-6 months are enough to prepare that subject there. Now, finally, I would like to know about your interview experience. Twice you have gone to interview. What the interviewers want to see in you?
Sir, basically, the knowledge has been tested in the prelims and mains examination. What the test finally in the personality test is, are you fit to be an administrator? So, my interview marks has actually jumped from 140 marks in 17 exam attempt to 179 marks, which is very
good jump, very,
very good jump to make my rank, pull my rank into the top 100. So, again, the approach has been changed from the earlier exam. Earlier, I used to put up points like the mains examination.
More on the facts based, right?
Mm-hmm. And I didn't substantiate enough by through examples of which would make interesting the conversation of the personality test. This time I had made sure that the conversation remains interesting and it focuses on the social aspects, which is what you do as an administrator. You focus on the people. So in that way, I have molded my approach towards personality test and I have reaped the dividends.
That's very good. That is a, basically, it is an assessment of your personality. They want to see your integrity, your emotional intelligence, leadership quality, and how you are honest in your approach there. So that is not a basically facts-based test. It is a more of assessment of different traits of personality, which are going to be suitable for civil services. That's very interesting. Now you have become IAS, and you have certain dreams in your mind. So what do you think you have right now, you can visualize where you would like to work on and focus on?
Sir, my key areas which I would focus on is education. And since most of the people focus on education and I also want to venture into areas like economy, be it agriculture, manufacturing. So, and work for the vulnerable sections of the society.
What message, Sumit, you would like to give to the students of your kind of background who come from villages and they have economic challenges in the family also? What would you like to say?
I want to give a simple advice to them that have confidence. When you have confidence, 50% of the battle is already won. After that, you frame the right approach and you ensure that you assess your strengths and weaknesses and work on it. Because most people are resistant to change in their strategies, in their approach.
Either they become inferiority complex people or superiority complex, right?
So it is important that you become flexible in your approach and accept of mistakes and then revise the approach and then succeed. So that is the thing. And I would like to quote the philosophy of Nishkam Karma in Bhagavad Gita, that you have to only do your work, the fruits or the results will automatically follow.
So basically when you do work sincerely, when the result and award also comes according. So God bless you, Sumit. You are, and best wishes for a wonderful career in IAS. God bless you.
Thank you.
I hope your success story discussion with me will help many to connect with you and they strategize for themselves.
Thanks. God bless you.
Thanks. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.